America is the land of pickup trucks, so it only makes sense that we produce some of the best. However, this is also the land of bigger is better. So with that being the case, do the smaller mid-size pickups get neglected? This is the Ford Ranger and the Chevy Colorado. And I do want to take a minute to stop and thank my subscribers for following and supporting the channel. It's because of you guys that I can justify putting all these hours into making these videos, so thank you so much. And if you're watching without being subscribed, I'd love to have you go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to stay up to date on all the new head-to-heads coming soon and any standalone reviews coming to the channel. Now, this isn't a normal head-to-head today. What I have with me is the 2019 Ford Ranger Lariat. Essentially what this embodies the peak of luxury and opulence within this segment. And on the other hand, we have something that's entirely the other direction. We have the Chevy Colorado ZR2 Bison trim. This foregoes all of that luxury to go for straight brutish off-road capability. Now we're gonna start with the luxurious Ranger Lariat. And the first thing that you're probably drawn to is the color, but it's not white, it's pearl, because luxury. And you know what else screams luxury? Chrome. You can just ask GMC. And we've got chrome in abundance up here, namely in the grille and the front bumper. And then around the side, we have even more chrome in the shape of your door handles, your mirror caps, your Lariat badge, your wheels, and even your running board. And then around back, we have the end of the chrome, namely the rear bumper and the tailgate release. When you do pull this, you will expose the 5-foot bed, which is good for 1,900 pounds of payload. And then one thing that's not chrome is your trailer hitch. Hook this thing up and you're good for 3,500 pounds of towing. Now we're talking about how luxurious this truck is, and that's great, but it's still a truck and it still has some muscle. Underneath here you have skid plates and you have a whole slew of underbody protection. And then around back you have seats and seat belts enough for 5, but I wouldn't necessarily recommend doing a cross-country trip with 3 adults in the back seat. However, you do have things like additional chargers and outlets, so you can have a more comfortable experience in the back seat. But up front is where you're gonna spend most of your time, so it's a good thing that Ford has done a great job with this interior, with super soft seats and really high-grade materials on everything that you interact with. Of course, this includes your steering wheel, which not only is leather wrapped and is incredibly well stitched, but it has a myriad of control buttons on here that control everything from your cruise control, your voice commands, and your semi-digital gauge cluster. And then to your right of that, you have Ford's SYNC 3 infotainment system, and it's one of the best in the biz. It's got all the modern features such as Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and a whole bunch of driver assistance systems. Ultimately, the cabin is ergonomic and it maximizes space so you never feel claustrophobic. It's well designed and it's just a nice place to spend time. Now, as we turn this thing on, we remember that it is still a truck and still has all the muscle that you would expect. It has the skid plate, it has the four-wheel drive setting, it has low-range gearbox, hill descent, and all that good stuff. The ride is comfortable and the cabin is fairly well refined and isolated. When you first start the truck, you will get a lot of induction noise coming into the cabin. It sounds really loud, it's just the engine getting up to temperature. Once it's a bit warmer, that dies down a lot more, and it is a very smooth and quiet place to be. It's very, very nice. And powering this bad Larry is a 2.3 liter EcoBoost turbocharged inline four cylinder spitting out 270 horsepower. And for those of you keeping track, that's almost 100 more horses than the Colorado. And you feel it. This thing feels so much quicker, so much more responsive. The Colorado is going to have it on torque because it's a diesel, but this thing just feels like a lot more fun and responsive. The steering is light, but it's precise, it's accurate, it's exactly what I want the truck to do, and the suspension composes the body in a way that's not too much lean. This is a fantastic truck if you just need something that you can get in, go, and drive every single day, but still has the capability and the practicality of being a light-duty truck. The Colorado, on the other hand, is a much more rugged and unapologetic beast. This is the Bison from AEV, which is American Expedition Vehicles. And essentially what this means is this is a package north of $5,000 that makes your truck indestructible, especially underneath. And we're gonna get to that in a minute. What we're gonna start with is aesthetics, and this thing looks mean as hell. The Bison is the only Colorado that gets the full Chevrolet spelled out in the grill. In the normal ZR2 model, you will get this kind of black mesh honeycomb grill, but it'll still have the bow tie in the center. This also gets a meaner front bumper and raised suspension. And then around the side, it's fairly subtle. You get a metal rocker bar here. You get plastic arch cladding for your wheels. You get smaller wheels and big knobby tires for more grip off-road. And then around back, things are pretty subtle, but they're pretty mean as well. You get these metal black rear bumpers, tow hooks, black bow tie, and when you open the tailgate, you get a 5-foot bed. The only thing is, this 5-foot bed is 800 pounds weaker than the Ranger's at only 1,100 pounds of payload. Where it makes up for it though is in this trailering hitch right here. This thing is good for 5,000 pounds of trailering. Now the reason for that could be twofold. First of all, you have all this reinforcement going on under the body with this AEV package. However, you also, under the hood, have a 2.8 liter turbo diesel from Duramax, giving you 369 pound-feet of torque. Now remember that almost 6 grand AEV package that's on this thing? Well, it's not just a skid plate. You have all of your bumpers that have been replaced with steel, you have a front skid plate, you have a gearbox and transfer case that's armored, you have so much underbody protection under here, so you won't puncture, break, or scratch anything under the body. You also get a pretty serious, almost 9 inches of ground clearance. You get multi-matic shocks, you get smaller wheels, and the big rubber that I was talking about earlier, so you have no worries when you're not on the tarmac. And jumping onto the interior, we'll start with the back. And just like the Ranger, there's not a whole lot going on back here. There's enough room. There might be a touch more in here than there is in the Ranger. You also get the same dual USB chargers, but where the Ranger had a normal house outlet, this just gives you a 12 volt. Also, only a single map pocket back here. And then moving up to the front of the cabin, we can see that this is one of the more dated options within the segment. The Colorado's been out for quite a few years now, and it's starting to show its age. Additionally, where the Ranger had really nice and premium materials, there's a lot of scratchy, hard plastics everywhere in here. My theory, though, is that they keep it like that so you're not afraid to hose it down when you get mud all over it when you come in from off-roading. Also, you don't get keyless entry. You have an actual key to start the car, and your seat adjustments are manual. However, it's not all medieval. You'll still have remote start, you have a wireless charging pad, and you have a nice touchscreen infotainment system that's completely modern with things like Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and Wi-Fi enablement. But to truly understand this truck, you have to drive it. And the first thing that I notice behind the wheel of the Bison is that it's immediately more comfortable and easier to live with on normal paved roads than the Tacoma TRD Pro that I had the other week. The Tacoma was so bumpy, the Fox shocks were so rigid. These Multimatic shocks on here absolutely behave in a normal and appropriate manner for the street. It's so much better. Now, one of the things that I don't love about this is that you do get a lot of road noise coming into the cabin. It's not super well damped. That could have something to do with the kind of plasticky materials, and there's not a lot of sound deadening in here. One of the actual noises that is fairly continuous anytime you go near the accelerator is the diesel engine. Like I said, this was a 2.8 liter turbo diesel from Duramax, making 186 horsepower and 369 pound-feet of torque. It's actually fantastic. I've loved it so far. I'm getting about 22, 23 mpg in combined driving, and this thing is rated at 22 mpg highway. So this thing is pretty underrated in terms of fuel economy, which is fantastic for something in this segment. Now the diesel is nice for fuel economy, but that torque is not necessarily translated directly into your everyday driving feel. You have to go really deep in the pedal to get that turbo to spool up and to get some actual power. The Ranger off idle feels like the lighter, more peppy truck, but this thing you can tell just has a brutish and muscular underbody. It's got power where you need it. It's gonna have grip where you need it. This thing I would trust more. The Ranger is going to be a little bit more fun. But ultimately, I'm just shocked at how well this thing is composed on the road. The shocks keep it so well damped, and the ride is incredibly smooth. The steering has a nice little heft to it. It's not a whole lot of feedback from these big knobby tires, but you get a little bit. It's just a really good ride for something that they've probably put 10 grand worth of stuff into to make it off-roady. So it behaves itself super well on the road. One complaint that I do have for both of these vehicles is you cannot get a sunroof. This is a $50,000 truck. I want a sunroof. And that's kind of beside the point. The main focus of this thing is being able to just destroy any sort of terrain.
with the upgraded wheel and tire packages, the upgraded suspension, the skid plate and underbody armor, all of the locking differentials, the transfer case, the low range gearbox, torque convert. It's everything about this truck is built and meant for you to go anywhere. And it's amazing.
So there you have it. These are the best offerings from the country that made trucks cool. And we have polar opposites showing that we have strengths in both directions. Do you want the well-equipped, luxurious, get-in-and-go daily driver? You get yourself a Ford Ranger Lariat. Or if you want to boldly go where no man has gone before, get yourself a Chevy Bison. And today we did talk a lot about the strengths of each of these vehicles. However, they're not just one-dimensional. This Ranger still has the muscle to get things done. It still has the underbody cladding to make it reasonably capable off-road. And this Colorado still has all of the modern amenities that make it a good and usable truck, with wireless charging and Apple CarPlay and Wi-Fi. What it comes down to is what you're going to use the truck for. This is a very purpose-built truck, and it's just about 50 grand with this almost $6,000 AEV package. This is 46-ish grand, so it's gonna be about $4,000 cheaper to get the top of the top in the Ranger. But if you really wanna take it off-road and push it, this is where you gotta go. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that thumbs up, leave a comment, subscribe, you guys know the drill. If you wanna see more off-road badassery, click this info card up here watching the Tacoma TRD Pro take on the Ford Raptor, or you can click the link down here and see some of the most angsty and rebellious crossovers go head-to-head.